So, welcome to our first cook-along. I'm Lucy Marvellous from Fresher Bites. Some of you will recognise me as Miss Marsden from when we've cooked together in your school. I thought we'd have a cook-along, seeing as I can't come into your school. So we're going to make a lovely pasta bake recipe from my little cookbook, Fresher Bites cookbook. So, if you're ready to go, if you've got your equipment and your ingredients from the recipe that you can get from either the website or my Facebook page at Fresher Bites or out of the little cookbook, hair tied back, hands washed, apron on, let's cook. I've got all my ingredients ready, I've got my equipment ready, so I just need to start with the method. First thing I'm going to do is put the oven on at 220. Here's my oven, I'm just going to turn it on. And I'm just going to check whether this is actually broadcasting before I go any further. Meanwhile, you can get your equipment ready if you haven't already. Some containers to cook in, your spring onions, bits and bobs. Okay, so you'll need containers to cook in, that's the first thing. These little tin foil ones are great for an individual portion because they're really thin, everything cooks really quickly. But you might not have any of those and you might want to cook for more people. So I've got a really nice glass one here that goes in the oven that's got a lid. So I can cook two portions in that one and one each in this one. So I've got my equipment ready, I've got my scissors, bits and bobs, and the first job after putting the oven on is to snip the onions, tomatoes and olives into the tray. We're using spring onions. Some of them are a little bit manky. I don't want those bits. I'm going to take those off. But then I am going to snip with my scissors one spring onion in each pot. So snip, snip, snip. You can join in with me. Snip, 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 snip. Like this. You want them quite small because you want to be able to pick them up with your fork or your spoon when you're eating. There we go. When you get to the end, there's a little hairy root. You don't need to eat that. You can if you want, but you don't need to. Okay, so look again. This bit's a bit not delicious. I'm going to take that bit off, put it in the compost, and then snip into my next pot. Snip, 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 snip. If you haven't got kitchen scissors, you can actually use any scissors that you've got in your house and boil them for 5 minutes to make sure they're nice and clean. Because if you've been doing craft work, you don't want glue and glitter. Okay. And this is for two people, so I'm going to snip two spring onions. Snip, 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 snip. This one is all lovely, so I can use all of it. There we go. Well, that's enough for two people. I've spread it out a bit in the tray as well so that everybody gets a bit of everything. So I've done the spring onions, now the black olives. Black olives come in a jar, a little bit salty. Some people worry that the flavour is going to be too strong, but once it's mixed in with everything, it's really delicious. So I need to check back on my ingredients list how many I need. I need three for each person. So three in there, and this is for two people. So how many do I need for this one? Two people, six. So all together I need three, three and six, that makes 12. You can use a little fork to get them out, or your fingers. Don't want too much of that salty liquid, which is called brine. So three, six, nine, 12. And these ones haven't got stones in, which is really handy because you can put your scissors right inside the little hole where they took the stone out. You cut them as big or as small as you like. I really like the taste, so I'm just going to cut them in half. So I've got some big bits. There we go. But if you know somebody who's not crazy about the taste, you might want to cut them a little bit smaller. Cut them in 4 or even in 8. So of course, because this is for 2 people, I'm putting 6 of those in there. My oven is heating up nicely, so that it'll be nice and hot when we put everything in. Now because this bigger tin is glass, it's going to take a little bit longer for the heat to get into it. So we need to cook that one a little bit longer. 2 sun-dried tomatoes. Now, sun-dried tomatoes are in oil. So I'm going to pick these out with a fork. I need 2 for each portion. So 2 for there, 2 for there. How many for that? 2 lots of 2 are 4. So I need 2 and 2. Mm, these are yummy. They look a bit weird, but they're literally tomatoes that have been dried in the sun. They're really tasty. 2 and 2 and another 2. There we go. So, this is when you would be glad you had a board because they're a little bit oily. So the easiest way to snip them is into long strips first, and then snip each strip into little pieces, just like that. And we want 2 for each person, so 2 in each pot. That's 1. These are really tasty. They'll give it a bit of a pizza flavour. Okay. That's 2 in that one. Will make one of your fingers a bit oily, so it's a good idea to have a little bit of hot soapy water there for washing your hands. Hopefully in your kitchen you've got a nice hot tap to wash your hands. There we go. So that's 2 each of those, and I need to put 4 in this one. I'm fairly sure this is not broadcasting. So in a second, I'm going to stop what I'm doing. See if I can make it broadcast. That's my 4. Okay, spread them around nicely. I'm finished with the scissors now, so they can go straight in the sink. If you've got some hot water in there, that's great. I've just got a washing up bowl here. Save me a bit of time. Right, well, I'm not sure whether you can see me or not. Facebook signed me out and is looking very confused about whether you can see me or not. So I've started without you, I'm afraid. I've cut my spring onions and olives and tomatoes from the recipe. So I guess if you can see me, we'll carry on. So we've already got them there. This is for two people. So I've got two spring onions, six olives, and four sun-dried tomatoes cut up. These are just for one person each. So I've got one spring onion, three black olives, and two sun-dried tomatoes snipped up in there. One more little bit of snipping to do, so I'll save that. Next, we are going to add our protein. We've got a choice of proteins. We've got haricot beans. These are in a tin. These are a really good source of protein. They're actually vegan, so people who don't eat meat or fish can eat those. So, ideally what you want to do is strain those to get rid of the liquid. They're a bit like baked beans, but without the tomato sauce, because we're going to make our own sauce. So it says, for each portion you need 2 tablespoons of cooked beans. This is a tablespoon cooked beans, but I'm going to make 2 portions. So 2 tablespoons would be enough for one person, but I'm making it for 2 people, so I need 4 tablespoons. There we go. And spread those out nicely. So they're a really nice protein sauce, really tasty. A little bit creamy when they're cooked. Protein choice is tuna for people who eat fish. This tin I need a tin opener for. Now, a tin opener has got 2 wheels on it. This one is got little teeth on it for gripping, and this one is sharp for cutting. So the gripping wheel goes underneath this little rim here, and then the cutting wheel pinches together. You have to squeeze the handles, and then when you turn this, the gripping wheel moves the sharp wheel round to open the tin. When you get nearly to the end, the lid will probably pop up. There you go, and that's when you can stop. So tuna, for each person, you need about a third of a tin of tuna, a spoonful. So you could make enough for 3 people with 1 tin. I'm just going to make enough for 1 person, so I'm going to put a third of a tin in there and spread it around nicely. Okay, for people who do eat meat, we're going to put in some cooked bacon. I've already cooked this morning, so I need my scissors that I've already put in the washing up. So again, like we did with the tomatoes, long strips, and then cut those into little pieces. So this one's the bacony one. Snip, snip, snip. Somebody who likes bacon. So it's a really versatile dish, which means you can change it around for different people who like different things. You could even put some pepperoni in or some leftover cooked chicken, but it needs to be cooked because it's not going to get long enough to cook in the oven. And finished with these things, they can pop in the washing up. Okay. So the next instruction says, weigh the pasta and add it to the tray. Snap spaghetti to fit. So if you're using spaghetti, you'll need to snap it. I'm using spirals. So here's our weighing scale. First job is to check that the arrow is pointing up to zero. You might have digital ones, which are easy. You just turn them on and they will set themselves to zero. We need, it says in the recipe, 50 grams of dry pasta for each person. I'm using this brown pasta. It doesn't take much longer to cook, but I like it. So 50 grams, let's have a look. That's two good handfuls. And it's now pointing at 50 grams. So two good handfuls for each person. So that's 50 grams in there. If you don't have scales, you can just use two good handfuls. If you've got much smaller hands than me, maybe three or four. It needs to fit in your pot. You can see it's just filling my pot pretty much. How much we need. Now this is for two people, so 50 for one person. How much for two people? 100. So we need to put in 100 grams for this one. Oop, a little bit too far, and take some out. My hands are clean, so it's time to put that back in there. The floor is not clean, so that one's got to go. Okay, so this is for two people. Spread it all around nicely like that. It's already starting to look lovely, isn't it? We don't need the scales anymore, we can get rid of them. Okay, what does it say to do next? Add the tomatoes. So I go back to the top of the recipe, half a tin of chopped tomatoes. We're going to use our tin opener again. Remember, it's got the teeth at the bottom here and the sharp bit at the top. The teeth click onto there. Sharp bit like this, and here we go. Turn, 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 and then it will just pop up as you get near the end. We want half on each of these. I pour it in and then have a look. There's about half left. That looks about right. These look quite full, don't they? I have to squish the lid on. And this tin, we can wash it up and put it in the recycling. Okay, so we've got that on. Then it says add stock powder and paprika. If you've got stock powder, that's great, but if you haven't, just put a bit of salt and pepper on. This is a vegan bouillon powder, which is really delicious. It's made of lots of different vegetables, dehydrated, smells amazing. So we're going to put a big pinch on each one, and because this is for two people, I've got my tomatoes on. So if it's half a tin of tomatoes per person, how many tomatoes do I need for two people? Half plus a half makes a whole. So a whole tin of tomatoes on there. And again, we can wash that tin and put it in the compost. So for two people, two pinches of bouillon powder or some salt and pepper if you don't have bouillon powder. And next, paprika. Pinch of paprika. This is another lovely, it's made from a pepper that's smoked. It's really delicious. I'm just going to put a shake rather than a pinch. A little bit of that and two shakes on this one. There we go. So that's all our ingredients used up. Now it says pour enough water over everything to just cover the pasta. So in the ingredients it says 100 millilitres of water, but really you just need to pour it in to cover the pasta. So if you're using the foil tray, pour it like this, just till you can see it creeping up. That's it. It needs to cover the pasta so the pasta can soak it up and make it nice and soft. There we go. That's just enough. And then here, of course, it's going to use a lot more because we've got twice as much pasta. Make sure it really covers it. any bits that are sticking out will stay crunchy, so I need to poke them in. And we'll poke them in with the lids on this one. Okay, we're about ready to go. Now these two, one's bacon and one is tuna. You, when you make yours, will choose what you want to have in. So you need to write your name on the one that is for you. So this one is bacon. I'm going to write bacon. This one is tuna. I'm going to write tuna. And then I'm going to push these lids down like this. You know what, I'm just going to check I've got those right. And I have. It's important to get them right. You can put your own name on them, you'll know it's yours. And then fold these, opposite sides first, and then corners. And you can see that's a really tight fit, which is going to be great because the pasta's going to get nice and wet and tomato-y and delicious. So this one's tuna. Squish it down. Oh, that one's going to burst over a bit. I put a lot of water in that one. That's okay. By now, your oven should be nice and hot. So these ones are going to go on this little tray. The dog, you can see wandering around. And this one, I've got a lid for. I'm just going to make sure that pasta's all poked under. The dog going through the dog door. This one's got a lid, so that's going to cook nicely too. My oven should be nice and hot by now. It says it is. I'm going to pop these in the oven for 25 minutes and I'll come back and hopefully be live in 25 minutes to show you when I open them. There we go. I'm going to set a timer on my phone for 25 minutes. See you then.